the running back position is becoming less and less valuable in the NFL, but if there is something that the NFL values, it's running backs that don't have a lot of mileage on their legs. Younger running backs do tend to get taken higher, especially if they have a good amount of college production, simply due to their age. We saw it last year with Wisconsin running back Braylon Allen being taken relatively high to the New York Jets, and I think this is a trend that can continue. Georgia running back Trevor Etienne is another one of these guys that I think has the potential to be taken very high in the 2025 NFL Draft. Etienne started his collegiate career at Florida before transferring to the Dogs in 2024, and he has put up some very solid numbers and will be just 20 years old at the time of the draft. A player who was the brother of Jaguars star running back Travis Etienne, how high could Trevor Etienne be taken in an absolutely stacked running back class? That is what we will be discussing in today's video. But hey guys, if you guys are new to the channel, consider hitting that like and subscribe button. I am battling a bit of a cold at the moment, so if my voice does sound off, I do apologize, but I do want to give you guys all the videos I possibly can. Be sure to check out my Patreon page, where for anyone who joins as a free member, you guys will get exclusive access to my full in-depth draft guide with over 500 players on my big board with in-depth scouting reports, size measurements, and much, much more. There will also be some more prospect interviews going up as soon as I can get some scheduled, and I highly recommend checking it out if you guys enjoy my NFL draft content. Leave a like, let me know down in the comments which players you guys would want to see on a future video, and without further ado, let's take a closer look at Trevor Etienne. Trevor Etienne was a pretty highly recruited back coming out of high school when he was a four-star recruit, and it was a big deal when he committed to Florida. In 2023, Etienne got 159 total rushing snaps, rushing for 756 yards and 8 touchdowns on the year. Florida was in a bit of a weird phase, and they continued to run the ball a lot with Montrell Johnson, and Etienne decided to enter the transfer portal and ultimately ended up joining the Georgia Bulldogs, and he has been a massive addition for the Georgia offense. He has run for 453 yards and 7 touchdowns in just 89 attempts this season. With his production and his age, he could be a heavily touted running back prospect at this year's draft. Etienne is a very quick running back prospect, and he possesses some very nice footwork for the position. It feels like time and time again, he shows the ability to make all sorts of cuts and jukes, and he has the ability to jump any run to the outside. He has excellent patience as a runner, and he possesses some incredible lateral quickness. But on top of that, he has some really good breakaway speed. He may not have the greatest long speed of all time, but I firmly believe he's going to be a low 4-4 guy. He can take the top off the defense, and he has produced 14 runs of over 10 yards this season for Georgia. Etienne also has some excellent vision for the running back position. He sits in the backfield, waiting for holes to open up, and when they do, he has the quickness and agility to hit the holes with anticipation. Vision is one of the most important characteristics for the running back position, and Etienne has that. He has the vision to see the holes open up, and he has the patience to wait for it and make a play, which is always a valuable trait to have. The other area of Etienne's game that really impressed me was his receiving upside. He has been a reliable part of the Georgia passing game, whether that be in the backfield, and he's even taken some snaps in the slot. I love what he provides as a receiving back. He has soft and reliable hands, and he shows some really nice route running out of the backfield as well. In the modern NFL, that is exactly the type of player that teams are looking for, and I think Etienne could be one of the better receiving backs in the NFL. The biggest issue with Trevor Etienne is his contact balance. Time and time again, it felt like if a defender touched him, he was likely going down on the play. He is averaging 3 yards after contact on the year, which is a pretty underwhelming number, and he doesn't really bring anything after contact. He's just not a very slippery back, and I would like to see him do a better job of breaking tackles, making guys miss, because that is the biggest issue in his game at this point in time. Etienne is a little bit undersized for the position. He's 5'9", 205 pounds, and he doesn't really have the size you look for to be an every down back in the NFL. He's not the type of runner that can consistently run between the sticks, and I think his size does limit him from hitting what his ceiling could potentially be, because he doesn't have every down upside at the next level. His size also limits him in the blocking game, where he really struggles to hold his ground, and was kind of a pushover at times in that area. Trevor Etienne is a super impressive back with his vision, his receiving upside, and his super impressive lateral quickness. But with the lack of contact balance and his lack of elite size, I think it could potentially hurt him in a loaded running back class. I am a big fan of what he could bring to the next level, but he is my number 6 running back so far in the class. Like I've said, it's a loaded class, and his lack of contact balance I think is a big deal that really does concern me about what his upside is at the next level. He is my number 102 overall player in the draft class. Etienne I think would work best in an outside zone rushing scheme. He works best when he runs the ball to the outside. He doesn't have the contact balance nor the power to consistently run the ball up the middle between the tackles, but with his quickness and his speed, I think he could thrive as a runner in an outside zone type of offense and be used as a receiving back as well. My player comparison for Trevor Etienne is Cincinnati Bengals running back Chase Brown. Brown is a super impressive athlete with good quickness and elite receiving upside, but he isn't the biggest nor is he the strongest runner. I would actually venture to say that Etienne has better overall vision and might have better overall footwork, but Brown has turned himself into a big part of the Bengals offense due to his ability in the receiving game and his speed, and I think Etienne has a very similar type of career path and trajectory. Trevor Etienne has excellent footwork. His quickness and vision for the running back position are exactly what you look for, and despite his size and contact balance issues, I think he could be a heavily touted running back prospect because of his age, and I do think he is a pretty versatile player who could be used on passing downs. He is a very nice running back prospect, and I believe that Trevor Etienne will be a top 100 pick in the 2025 NFL Draft.